Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize the dropdown tree component using built-in templates. This component supports several template options to customize dropdown tree items and header and footer elements. Looking at this example, you can see the dropdown tree pop-up showing employee names, designations, and images. You can also see the pop-up with a customized header and footer. Now, I will show you the steps to achieve this customization using my existing React Dropdown Tree application. Let me open my application where I have added the React Dropdown Tree with basic properties. I have bound employee details as the data source and set the placeholder property value as select an employee. Follow the link provided in the YouTube card to learn the basics of adding a React Dropdown Tree to an app. You will also find a reference link in the description below. Now, I will run this example using the npm start command. Here, see the dropdown tree showing employee names. Next, I will demonstrate how to add images and employee designations to items. Here, I want to display an employee name, designation, and image in each item. So, modify the existing dropdown tree data source by adding two more fields, eImage and job. To customize items, first add the item template property and set the value as item template. Then, define the function item template. Inside this function, I define division and image elements with the class name eImage to set custom styles to the image. Then add the source path using a source attribute and set an alternate name for the image. Next, add employee names and designations to the items. So, let me create two more division elements with appropriate class names. Then assign this data source field's name and job to the division elements using a data parameter. Following this, I want to add the CSS class to the pop-up element, which allows you to customize the appearance. I define the CSS class property with the class name DDT template. Then within the app CSS file, add styles like padding, margin, font size to align the image and employee details. Now, see the dropdown tree component showing the employee names, designations, and images. Next, let me show you how to add a header to the pop-up. For that, I set the header template property to header template. Then define the function header template, which receives argument of type JSX element. Within this function, define a division element with the text employee list. Define CSS styles for the header template, like margin, padding, line height, and more to align the header text. As you can see, the pop-up displays the text employee list as the header. To show the total count at the bottom of the pop-up, I use the footer template. Within the dropdown tree tag, add the footer template property and set the value as footer template. Then define the footer template function, which receives argument of type JSX element. Inside this function, I define the division and span elements with the text total list items 8. Here, I have shown a static count of the total list items in the footer. However, you can also display dynamic count of items from the data source and add CSS styles to the footer template, like border top, font size, line height, and text indent to align the footer text. Looking here, the pop-up is displays 8 at the bottom. Next, I want to display the count of all selected items in the dropdown tree when one or more items are selected using checkboxes or multi-selection support. First, I enable the checkbox in the component by setting the show checkbox property to true. Next, I need to set the mode as custom. So, I set the mode property to custom. To display the count of selected items, I add the custom template property and assign the selected length using the value property with the text content that will be displayed after the count. Following this, I would like to enable the automatic selection of relevant items when both the child and parent tree items are checked or unchecked. To achieve this, I set the tree settings property and set the autocheck property value to true. See, when I select items, the selected items count is displayed in the dropdown tree component. Finally, I will show you how to customize the dropdown tree using the noRecords template property. For that, I add the noRecords template property and set the value as noRecords template. Then define the function noRecords template which receives argument of type JSX element. Within this function, add the division and span tags with the value noData available. Next, remove all other properties from the dropdown tree tag. Then remove the other templates from the code. Now, when you look at the dropdown, the pop-up displays no content. In this video, I have shown you how to customize the dropdown tree items and add a header and footer template. If you would like to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React Suite through our community license if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.